Ladies and gentlemen, and as we mentioned earlier, we're going to be talking today on the healthy eating habits during the holy month of Ramadan. And on this occasion, as we are on the first day of Ramadan, we would like to extend our greetings to all Muslims around the world and of course to all our dear viewers. And on the topic of healthy eating habits during Ramadan, we're glad to be joined today by Professor Dr. Nabiha Abdel Hamid, Director of Food Safety Information Center. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Dr. Nabiha. Dr. Nabiha, to start with, we are starting the holy month of Ramadan. Of course, this year it comes during a hot weather. So how can we take the proper food in order to avoid being thirsty all through the day, because the fasting hours are quite long as well?
Yes, fasting hour is 16 hours today, and the weather is better today than yesterday, and I hope it will be all Ramadan like this. The more things we lose during the fasting is water and blood glucose level. So at the end of the day, we have to start by adding some of these things to our meals in the beginning. And as our Prophet promised us and told us to do, is to start with dates. Dates is a very nice fruit, contain a lot of sugar, which is absorb directly, don't need digestion. So if we start with three or five fruits of dates, either soaked in water or soaked in milk, it is a good idea to increase directly the blood glucose level and to enhance the activity of the stomach and to prepare the body to take the meal. That is the first thing we start with. And after taking this, we had to go to pray al Maghrib first to give the body 5-6 minutes already to start working with the enzyme system in the digestive tract and give the activity more to the blood in the brain. You know, the glucose almost when it decreases in the brain, you feel headache. And this is very good idea to just solve all this problem in the beginning.
Right.
The second dish should be something to improve also situation inside the tract.
Could be soup or salad.
It should be soup first, but not with creamy soup.
Yes, it was my question, doctor, because sometimes we do tend to make some heavy soups like cream of tomato or mushroom
out from Ramadan with less weight and better health.
So some
not soup. The creamy ones.
Not the, not creamy, the creamy one. Soups. You can take the broth only of just chicken or meat and add some green spices, vegetables like celery and something like that. And after having not big one, I mean just 100 milli or something of this soup will be enough. But we had to take after that a big dish of salad, which contain all the colors. We would like to have tomato for lycopene. We had to have green, leafy green vegetables for chlorophyll and as antioxidant and for all the, we contain most of the trace elements and vitamins.
Lettuce and cucumber.
Lettuce and all these things will give you trace elements, will give you vitamins soluble in water, and will give you also a lot of growth fiber. So you will feel full. And after that, to start the main dish.
After that, we'll have another
main dish.
You will not eat a lot. You will eat 3 spoons of rice, not more than that, you will feel. And not more than 100 gram of meat or half a quarter of chicken.
Half the quarter of chicken.
Have a quarter of a chicken.
Not even a quarter.
Not a quarter even.
Well, for because we don't need protein to build our body. Mm-hmm. Already
but what about the younger generations?
They need more than us.
Of course.
They need more protein.
They need more protein because they are in the building time to build their body. But already we don't like to lose also. Mm-hmm. So we take to maintain your weight and to the composition inside your body because mm-hmm. Protein also not only for the building but for the enzyme production inside the cell mm-hmm. comes from the protein also which we are eating. Mm-hmm. So and after having this meal, you can have some fruits.
Mm-hmm. What about sweets?
Well, sweets that we had to just taste mm-hmm. because if you go for 100 grams of kunaf, it contains more than 40% of its weight fat. Mm-hmm. Means you have 450 calories from coming from fat and 200 coming from sugar.
But there's a lot of attractions in Ramadan.
It is okay, but
sweet,
you just can
especially in sweets.
Just taste, not to eat the 100 gram. Mm-hmm. Don't be blocking and be something I don't like. But just eat, but eat some of it. Mm-hmm. Not to eat 100 gram or 150 as people did. And because we after having the meal, the people used to stay,
right?
And looking for the TV and having 6 hours sitting, it mm-hmm. is a very bad thing.
They don't do any activity after
that's
eating.
That's very bad thing. They should go to pray al Tarawih at mm-hmm. the mosque mm-hmm. and come back after 2 or 2.5 hours. Mm-hmm. It is enough for digestion. Mm-hmm. And if you need some snacks, just go for peanut, for groundnut, for some, not much, mm-hmm. 5-6 fruits or something like that, mm-hmm. not 100 kilo, not mm-hmm. 100 gram, not half a kilo or something as the people did. Mm-hmm. At the end of the month, you will lose weight, you will keep yourself mm-hmm. healthy, and at the suhoor, don't eat it early, make it very late, mm-hmm. before mm-hmm. al-fajr.
Mm-hmm. What about smoking, sir? What about smoking? How can people reduce smoking during the Ramadan? I mean, after the iftar.
It is a habit. If you all the day 16 hours you don't smoke, why don't continue? Stop smoking because that is one of the ways.
But most of the smokers. Mm-hmm. After they eat iftar, they start smoking as usual.
Yes.
I know.
How can they control this? How can Ramadan and the fasting time help them out to reduce smoking?
It is something sociology. They had to be stronger in facing the bad habits. Mm-hmm. How to stop this bad habit? It is a bad habit. Mm-hmm. All of us knows that. Mm. And he knows better than us, and he is not only smoking as a person, all his family
negative
is
smokers.
negative smokers beside
right.
him, especially the children.
Dr. Nabi, what about the fluids and the amount of the suitable amount of water and fluids that we should be taking?
Supposed to drink about 2 liters of water after from Al Maghrib till Al Suhoor. That's the least amount. It should be more
in
than
any
that.
Form or water?
Any form.
Juices or?
But juices should be with the natural sugar only. Mm. Don't add anything more. Mm-hmm. If you have any type of natural drinks like orange juices, like whatever you can have at
what
home.
What about the traditional juices of or Amar drinks Deen. Of Ramadan like Amaruddin, apricot, dried apricot, or
dried
hibiscus?
Apricot is very good, mm. but don't add sugar. Mm. Just mm-hmm. use the natural sugar inside it. When you soak the leather of the apricot, just soak it in water, don't add
sugar, because sugar. It's already sugar.
Some sugar.
It doesn't need more sugar.
And doesn't need more. Mm-hmm. But also, we had to drink not much.
Just one glass.
One glass mm-hmm. and less. Go for the green tea, better also after having this. and enjoy your time with praying at the mosque, and you will have 2 hours moving and doing something. Because you know, in the new guidelines for the food pyramids, you, if you look for it, you see the exercise almost one of the items beside choosing type of food. You had to exercise yourself, you had to walk, you had to do something as a physical activity beside the eating diversity.
So physical activity should take place during the fasting hours better, or after the fast, after
if,
the iftar?
If you like to do it during the fast, it should be before the Maghrib with 20 minutes. Because if you lose some water by sweetness or something, you will have it after 20 minutes, you can recover. But don't,
not early in the morning.
Don't do it very early, or if you can do it at 7, 8 early at the club for 30 minutes or something, you will not lose water at that time. But if you don't do it, just keep it late. And you have also time after having the breakfast, you can go for half an hour walking or something. It is very important. It's very, very
regarding
important.
People with diabetes, what's the best way out for them to deal with the food during after the iftar?
Well, it is a chance for them to have a good system for them. They may not need to have medication or medical treatment at Ramadan if they go only for the natural sweets, natural sweeteners, not just to
you mean fruits, natural
fruits,
sweets?
Fruits and if they eat a lot of dried figs and the other things, it should be with less sugar, with no sugar coming from outside. And also the amount of the food itself should be calculated for them.
Of course. Dr. Nabi, what about the amount of food that we should be eating eating during suhoor meal?
Suhoor, it should be...
We do eat the suhoor meal and then sleep, so it's not a very healthy...
Well, we had to make it very late until al-fajr. Before al-fajr was 20 minutes, you can start finishing your suhoor. And at that time, you will take a meal. It is not just a snack. Because you are going to work all the day after that with this meal, energy. You can take full madamis, you can take cheese, you can take yogurt.
But what kind of food? Because we would try to avoid being thirsty the other day after.
Big dish of salad contain a lot of trace elements and minerals inside it. Will keep all the water inside, because less salt, less minerals in the food will make you lose a lot of water.
So why
so
is
take a complete meal with diversity as a meal. But when you make it late, you will have you will finish at 10 to 3 or something, and you walk and you pray al-fajr, and you stay for half an hour reading Quran or something, and you sleep.
Why is fasting healthy, in your opinion?
Fasting healthy is if you analyze your blood profile, and especially the fatty acids profile, and triglycerides, and LDL, and HDL. Before Ramadan and after Ramadan, you will find the difference. Because if you really eat well, diverse, and you have things just controlled, as we said, you will find all these parameters is well managed and well controlled after Ramadan. But if you are like the Egyptians, making Ramadan a month of meals, and eating, not a month of fasting. If you go now for any supermarket or hypermarket, you will see how much the people are buying from the food material and the ingredient. It is not really a fasting month.
Yes, Dr. Nabih, that would bring me to ask you this question, because as you have kindly mentioned that for certain people it's a month of eating more. We will find during the month of Ramadan many invitations, family gathering, or
banquets.
So you find a huge amount of food.
Well, that is very good, but we have to change our culture.
Yeah.
When we make these meals for our guests, we don't look for the
huge
diversity.
You find a huge quantity.
We give only amount of meat, a big amount of chicken, a big amount of fried and everything. Even if we have 5 persons, we have a meal for 20. That is the way we did our, that is the bad in our habit. Mm. We had to make it according to the number of the people are going to eat.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. As a person, not as a guest. But we are trying to show everybody that we are happy with them, giving them something they don't need to eat. Sometimes when I invited some of my foreign friends at Ramadan at my home, my children and all the people, or almost everybody like to offer something.
Yes.
And the person shy to say no.
On this, right?
And at the end of the day, he feel bad because he eat a lot.
Of course, and especially after 16 hours of fasting, it's quite complicated to eat a huge amount.
We don't. The culture is good. People visiting,
gathering together,
and eat together. But we have to do it according to the healthy meals and the amount needed to the body.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think somebody need to eat 1 kilo of meat?
Of course not.
We offer that.
But what are the most important types of food that should be totally avoided during Ramadan?
Large amount of meat, large amount of chicken.
The things
the fried,
that you could do eat.
The sweet
yes,
things.
Exactly. Sweets, especially sweets.
Dr. Nabih, usually when you go to a gathering and everyone who is invited is taking with him a sweet
thing.
You find a huge amount of
sweets.
Yes, and people
right,
are
so
enjoying that very much.
That is a very bad habit we had in our society. We show our welcome people by giving them several meals and big meals, and that is not really what we should do. We should concentrate on the healthy meals, on the diversity of the meals, on something which could be benefitable for everybody.
Mm-hmm. What about children fasting? What would you advise them to eat, or advise the parents to do for them?
During the iftar time, they are grow well and they're healthy. They are healthy. They can fast.
Mm-hmm.
But with less playing at the sun shine and about the open areas,
mm-hmm.
they had to reduce the activity during the day so not to lose glucose from their blood and feel headache or something at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
So
in order to avoid having a headache, Dr. Nabih, what should we do during the previous day after Suhoor? Mm-hmm. Should we take certain fruits, certain amount of fluids?
So the amount of fluids is very important. As I told you, it should not less than 2 liters.
Yes.
It should be more.
Mm.
And we have this kind of juices, and it contain a lot of minerals, and this is very important to keep the water inside the body because it is very important, and also the dish of salad as a diversity. And that is, if you do it, you will not feel headache.
Mm.
And in the same time, don't exercise much.
Mm.
If you are exercising during the fasting, beginning of the day, that's not good. You can exercise at the end of the day before iftar.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Nabih, as the director of the Food Safety Information Center, I would like you to tell us about the junk food, the issue of the junk food during the Ramadan and even during the, throughout the year, throughout the whole year. How do you see junk food as opposed to other types of food, home food?
It is already a habit transferred from
the West
to us, mm-hmm. and we had something equal like Ta'amiyya and Ful Falafel and all these things already.
But Ta'amiyya and Ful Falafel is not as unhealthy as the junk food.
It is healthy. That's what I coming. I would like to tell you, we transferred from our good habit to the bad habit.
Mm-hmm.
And because other fast food having a lot of fat inside it.
Mm-hmm.
Because the fat almost, you know, had a good taste and good flavor. So they attracted the children and the young people to eat much from their product because of this high amount of fat.
And it's one of the main causes of obesity, I think.
It is one of the main causes of obesity.
In children, especially in children.
Mm-hmm. And the obesity in Egypt became very tough problem.
Mm-hmm.
Almost more than 50% of male and females
mm-hmm.
are tend to be more obese or had a problem with their weight.
Mm-hmm.
And you know the impact of this on the heart disease and all this is very known and very expensive for our
mm-hmm.
country.
Mm-hmm.
If you go for the hospitals and see the number of people who are hospitalized mm-hmm. regarding this issue is very big.
Mm-hmm.
It's very big.
Mm-hmm.
And also these working hours for the young children and for the youth is almost diminished, and this is not good for mm-hmm. the economy.
Mm-hmm. Right. Dr. Nabih Abdelail Abdel Hamid, Director of Food Safety Information Center, many thanks, sir, for joining us.
Thanks.
And happy Ramadan to you.
Thank you very much. Happy Ramadan, and have a good Ramadan all the time.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And with that, our dear viewers, we come to the end of our first segment for today. Now we'll go to a short break, and after that, we'll be back to resume the segments of the breakfast show, so don't go away.